And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Our next bout tonight, three rounds, this in the atomweight division. Introducing first, finally out of the blue corner, a mixed martial artist standing 5 feet, 1 inch tall. Weighing in officially 104 and one half pounds, she brings a perfect record into the cage. 4 victories and no defeats. Finally out of Everett, Washington, here is the undefeated Julia Jules Jones. And her opponent across the cage, finally out of the red corner, a mixed martial artist standing 5 feet, 4 inches tall. She weighed in 105 and one quarter pounds and enters the cage tonight for the 10th time as a professional. Finding out of Denver, Colorado, here is Stephanie the Scrapper Skinner. And referee in charge, once again, Mike England.
Julia Jones, Stephanie Skinner, atomweight set to go. Mike England, our referee. Enjoy live and exclusive events, original programming, and the largest MMA library on UFC Fight Pass. Download the UFC.tv app today, anytime, anywhere. It is your pass to the Ultimate Fighting Championship. Skinner standing orthodox. Jones, southpaw.
Interesting fakes coming from Skinner there.
Saw the difference in kicks there. Skinner's kick landed a little bit more flush than Jones. Adam White's flurrying early.
It's the third time Skinner's actually caught that leg. Oh, and Jones catches her leg now. It looks like more of a guard pull than an actual takedown happened right there.
This left hand there as she entered the guard from Jones. See Skinner set up shop here, closed guard now, trying to bring it high. And she does, trying to frame up, it looks like for a triangle, doesn't have the arm cleared though.
Jones has some good composure right here, you know, trying to keep that nice base.
Oh, armbar upcoming here by Skinner. Jones gonna have to defend here. Jones trying to stack a little bit. What's she got to do to get out of this, Julia?
She's got to keep herself composed. Like I said earlier, she's got to connect those hands, and she's got to pull that elbow out from between the legs of Skinner. She's posturing up like that is kind of dangerous because it can get her to an extended position. It looks like she's still defending pretty well, but that is very, very dangerous to kind of pull out like that. But she's out now. She's passed through. She's got Skinner on her back, flat on her back again, and the arm is in no danger anymore.
Nicely done by Jones. Now sets up shop in the half guard. Half guard enjoyed by a lot of fighters. Some people enjoy the half guard even more than traditional full mount. You can control your opponent a lot better from that position.
Yeah, and I think there's actually a few more submissions you can get from half guard than you can from mount. Because mount, you just really want to hit them. You have it in a position of total, you know, dominance there.
Oh, nice elbow there by Julia Jones.
Goodness.
Skinner's going to have to try to move. She does, but look at that. Nice transition by Jones. Landing more elbow. Skinner eating it.
And Skinner turned down for that. She's kind of giving up her back right here. Jones is going to take advantage of that with some heavy strikes again.
Julia Jones showing that she has a lot of ground and pound in her repertoire. Skinner definitely uncomfortable here, and a lot of time for the Washington native to work. Rear naked choke upcoming.
It looks like it's over the chin. It's not quite in yet.
Oh,
no,
there
it's under,
it is. Julia Jones trying to choke out Stephanie Skinner. It is done. Julia Jones victorious in her Invicta FC debut.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes at the official time, 2 minutes 38 seconds, round number one. We have your submission by rear naked choke and your winner. She is still undefeated, Julia Jules Jones. Well, fine fans, we are set to go with our next bout tonight, three rounds, and this in the strawweight division. Introducing to you first, finally out of the blue corner. She is a wrestler standing 5 feet 5 inches tall. Weighing in at the strawweight limit, 116 pounds. Tonight, she makes her professional debut. Finding out of Medford, Oregon, here is 50 Cal Holiday! And next, her opponent across the cage, finding out of the red corner, a Muay Thai fighter, standing 5 feet 4 inches tall. She weighed in 114 and three quarter pounds, and also tonight making her professional debut fighting out of San Diego, California. Here is Tiffany Timebomb Van Zoom. And your referee in charge of the action is Mark Wasson.
Mark Wasson getting this assignment. It is Cal Holiday taking on the time bomb, Tiffany Van Soest. TJ DeSantis, Julie Kedzie, Scottish Rite Temple here in beautiful Kansas City. Cal Holiday takes the center of the cage.
Oh, she just kind of bum rushes in like that. Not a lot of technique setting that up, but she is on the inside, and she has Van Soest down to the ground.
The kickboxer now on her back. We'll see what Van Soest can do. This is not her world. Cal Holiday lands a couple left hands.
Holiday's doing a nice job of keeping her pinned up against the cage. Van Soest needs to get to her feet right here. But she's eating some pretty hard shots on that journey up.
Hard left hands here by Holiday. Van Soest able to get back to her feet. We'll see if she can get free of the grip of Cal Holiday. And back elbow. Wrestling on display, the grappling ability here of Cal Holiday. Working so far, she has one hook in, Julie. We'll see if she can try to get that second one. The fence may inhibit her from doing so.
Yeah, and it's very smart of Vince to push her up against a fence like that, try to get her her hip in action and scrape her with the fence off of the cage. However, Holiday's right hand was in play. Vince is turning in now. Her neck is not in danger at the moment, and she's able to get the underhook there.
Newly crowned UFC middleweight champion Michael Bisping defends his belt in front of his hometown of Manchester, England, and looks to avenge the most devastating loss of his career at UFC 204 when he takes on the future Hall of Famer Dan Henderson. It's live Saturday, October 8th, only on pay-per-view. Again, Holiday shooting in to see if she can finish this takedown. Van Soest trying to widen her base, but Holiday relentless here, Julie.
She is, but Van Soest is doing a nice job of splitting the legs right there, keeping the hands from connecting for Holiday. Holiday's able still to muscle her down to the ground. You can see Van Soest is working to get up, but look, Van Soest's left arm is trapped across her body. Holiday can use that to get to a head and arm choke right here.
She's obviously not where Tiffany Van Soest wants to be, but her experience at the highest level, probably, you know, able to compose her here. Now look at her introduce the legs into this move.
Yeah, she's doing the same thing Greenway was doing, climbing up in the cage, trying to cross-face the head actually with her own thigh.
Look at that right arm of Van Soest. It is trapped there by the left leg of Holiday.
Yeah, that's not a great position to be in. She really needs to use those legs on the cage and pull herself out from underneath.
Halfway point here of round number one. It's been all 50 Cal Holiday.
She's still composed here. She's scrambling. She knows the right things to do. She's just got to execute.
Oh. Nicely done by 50 Cal Holiday.
My
hard right
goodness.
Hand compliments a beautiful takedown.
Ooh, rah.
Now she's trying to fish for that one naked choke. Van Soest in a lot of trouble.
Did I say the right thing there?
I'm going to go yes.
Goodness. RNC is in there. She's trying to straighten her out now. You can see Van Soest is still defending, but she's getting flattened out. This is a bad position for Van Soest.
Van Soest in a lot of trouble. 50 Cal Holiday trying to end it right here. A lot of time to work. A touch under 2 minutes. Squeezing is Holiday. Van Soest still holding tough for the time being.
Her legs are still in place. She's not out. She's still working. It looks like her chin is not all the way. Oh, there she goes. She gets out of the RNC.
By Tiffany Van Soest. She stays in this fight. Nice readjustment there by Holiday.
Holiday's like sticking to her just like a backpack.
Tiffany Van Soest getting tested here early and thus far not wilting, but this is a hard squeeze, heavy squeeze here by Holiday.
Van Soest is doing a good job fighting hands, trying to pry her off. Holiday is in a great position to start working and throwing some strikes to open up that neck.
Well, she's got the body triangle on here. Van Soest trying to roll to her left.
Look at the way. Look at the way Van Soest used her thumbs, under the elbow to free her neck. That was very well done. She's still in quite a bit of danger now.
I like Holiday mixing it up, going for some strikes, trying to get the opening, and then immediately back to that choke.
That's exactly what you need to do. You need to soften people up with those strikes to get where you need to go to get the tap.
Less than a minute remains here. Van Soest, though, very composed, been a lot of trouble.
Oh,
and now she rolls into the guard of Cal Holiday. Van Soest trying to make up for lost time.
Well done by Van Soest. Really showing a well-rounded game. Nice
Nicely
kick.
Done. Push kick to the face there. Oh. Hard right here by Van Soest. Holiday in trouble.
And she sees she's going for that takedown again. It was so successful before. Can she get her back to the ground? She can. Big slam.
That is the determination of a Marine. She took Van Soest heavy shot there, came forward, and now she's back on top to end this round. 15 seconds left in this opening round.
Look at that. She's doing a great job walking her legs up there and actually trying to go for the armbar. That's beautifully done.
Cal Holliday trying to punch out of this here, Julie. Sorry to cut you off. Final moments here. Very dangerous spot here for Cal Holliday.
Wow.
Round two underway. Van Soest had a flash of brilliance on the feet. We'll see if she can implement that here to start our second round. I'm sure that's in the back of Cal Holliday's mind. Nice kick there, though, by the former Marine. I guess once a Marine, always a Marine.
That's true. I hope I didn't offend anybody. I don't know if I said the right thing there. Nice kick from Van Soest. Beautiful. Look at the way she wedged that head, too. But Holliday's able to move through it and get to that leg. Van Soest is attacking Holliday's hand while she's trying to get those elbows off. She's got great balance, but that single to the double transition is always going to work right there.
Cal Holliday showing her wrestling ability here, actually making it a bit of a dirty boxing affair up against the fence, but Van Soest, very clean, lands a nice right hand.
You have to wonder if that sharp knee on the inside made Holliday want to disengage right there. Van Soest has some very powerful knees. And you know, Holliday did well when she threw that kick. I think she should actually throw more kicks. I think it's throwing Van Soest off. Oh!
Van Soest went for a spin. She got her back taken, and Holliday does what she does best, drags her to the floor.
Hard
right hands. Beautiful hammer fist by the wrestler.
And she's got to watch the back of the head right there, but it looked like the feeling to the side. Again, she's on the back. Again, she's underneath the neck, trying to get that. I can't see if it's under the neck. I think that it is right now.
Palm-to-palm grip here for Holliday. Van Soest looked like she's going to try to stand for a moment. Now she's fighting hands.
That's a good thing to do. I think she needs to get to a position where she can pry her off. No, she's not under the neck. She's actually across the chin. It's painful.
That's
but
a
it
hard
can,
crush, yeah.
Yeah, it can be worked out of it. Man, she's got to stay composed right now.
Composure has been the name of the game for Tiffany Van Soest. Cal Holliday has been very aggressive, trying to make her pay
and
once again.
Holliday needs to do right here, honestly, is pull her shoulders back, engage her traps, engage her her back muscles, and pull into that to put more pressure on the chin. Oh, it looks like she's under the chin, but Van Soest is still defending.
Van Soest in a lot of trouble here. Cal Holliday really squeezing.
My goodness.
You see the face there of Tiffany Van Soest in trouble. And it's done. Cal Holliday upsets the time bomb, Tiffany Van Soest.
What a fight, TJ.
Martinez.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes with the official time of 2:08. Round number two. We have your submission by rear naked choke and your winner, 50, Cal Holliday.